Right, so today we're going to be writing measures 1 through 4 of Happy Blues for Viola. So what you'll need is your music staff paper and a pencil. And if you didn't get this paper in class at school, you can go to my website and under the music tab, you can download it. It is labeled music staff paper blank. And there are two sides. I can show you. One side, side one, has a music staff that's spaced farther apart, and side two has a music staff that's spaced closer together. It doesn't really matter which one you use. If you like to write small, you might prefer to write on the smaller side. I do, that's my preference, but today I'm going to write it on the larger side, because some people prefer the larger side and it is easier when we're learning. If you don't have your own music staff paper, if you don't have it from me or you can't print it from my website, then you can create your own by just using a ruler and some blank paper and drawing 5 lines across, and just make sure that they're neat and make sure that they're evenly spaced apart. Okay, so let's get started here. The first thing that we're going to do, the first thing that we always do, is write our name on our paper. So you always want to write your first and last name on any work that you do. That way, if it ever gets lost, people know whose it is. Your teacher will know whose it is. If it gets lost somewhere else, like in the cafeteria or something, everybody will be able to give it back to you. So you won't have to redo something. And this is Viola, so I'm going to check Viola, and Violas are in 5th period. And I'm going to put on here the title. I'm just going to put it right over here. So this is Happy Blues, and I'm going to put by, and the composer. His name is Robert Frost. Okay, so there's our title, Happy Blues by Robert Frost. So the first thing that we have to draw is our treble clef. I'm sorry, our alto clef, because this is for violas. Alto clef. Now the good news is it's half easy and half difficult. So let me break it down for you. We have a thick line, a thin line, then we have 2 backwards C's in kind of like a triangle or an arrow. So if I flip this around, you'll really be able to see the C's here, C and C. Okay, so what we're gonna do first is draw the thick line, and we're gonna start right here at the end and draw our thick line of our alto clef, and then draw a thin line. And then I like to add next the C's, and so I'm gonna do 1 C here, and remember they're backwards C's, 1 and 2. That one's a little funny looking. Okay, and then we're going to put our arrow, and our arrow points to the middle line. So it's going to start at the end of the C, point to the middle line, start at the end of the C, and point to the middle line. So that's what it looks like. Okay, if you need to pause this video or rewind and go back and do it again, you can do that. All right, so after our clef, the next thing that we need to put on our paper is a meter. Now the meter tells us how many beats are in the measure and what kind of note gets the beat. So this means there's 4 quarter beats in the measure, 4 quarter beats. So I'm going to show you how I draw a meter, and I'll show you some other ways on another piece of paper. So the way I draw the meter is I start at the top and I just make 1 line going all the way down. And then I do a 4 in the top 2 spaces, and I make a 4 in the bottom 2 spaces so that it looks like that. Now it is actually 2 separate numbers. So if you wanted to, what you could do is you could go like this, 4, 4, or you could do regular 4s. You could do like this, 4, 4, or you could do a line and 4, 4 like that. However you want to do it, whatever works best for you is fine. So the next thing that we're going to put on our music staff before we can start writing our music is bar lines. Okay, so I'm going to start with a bar line here at the end, and it just closes the music staff down like that. Okay, and now when we put more bar lines on, then we create what are called measures. So the space in between the two bar lines is a measure. So I'm going to make some measures on here. I need to make 4 measures. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to start at the from my meter and go to this bar line. And I'm going to see where I think the middle is. I think the middle is about right here. So I'm going to draw a bar line here. And then I'm going to put a bar line in between these where I think is the middle. And then I'm going to put a bar line in between these wherever it looks like it's the middle. Okay, it's not perfect, but it's pretty close. That way we get 4 evenly spaced measures, and that's what we're gonna need. Now, before we start writing our music, we're gonna number our measures. So we don't need to number measure 1 because it's super obvious that's measure 1. But starting here, right on this bar line, on the right side of it, I'm gonna put a 2. And then on the right side of this one, I'm gonna put a 3. And on the right side of this one, I'm going to put a 4. So this is measure 1, this is measure 2, measure 3, and measure 4. Okay? So now let's look at Happy Blues. We'll look at the first line of Happy Blues. Here it is. So we have D, D, rest, 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 D, 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 rest, 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 D, 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 D. So that's what we're going to do. So the first thing that we need to know how to do is to be able to draw a quarter note, okay? Now the first 2 notes are not quarter notes, they're eighth notes, but the way you make eighth notes is you start with quarter notes, okay? So here's what we're gonna do. In the beginning, I'm gonna draw 2 quarter note Ds. So if you look at the note head, it looks like an egg, not a circle, okay? So over here, I'm going to find the space D, and the space D is the 3rd space, 1, 2, 3, here. And I'm going to do here and here. Now, one thing I need to do, actually, is flip this around, because our stems need to go downward on measure 1 when we're playing D. So I'm going to draw the stem on the left side of the note head and go down past the music staff, and I'm going to do the same thing on this one, go past the music staff. I went maybe a little too far. I might erase that a little bit. Okay, now I have to make them into eighth notes, so now I have to connect them with a beam like this. So I'm going to do that by drawing my beam across the bottom, and then I'm going to make it thicker. There we go. So those are my eighth notes. Now we've done our quarter notes and our eighth notes. And so now we have to add some rests, and we're gonna add in our quarter rests. Now there's a trick to drawing quarter rests. If you can see, this kind of looks like a Z and then a C. So that's what I'm gonna do. Over here, I'm gonna start under the 4th line, and I'm gonna draw a Z and then a C. And I'm gonna do it 2 more times because we need 3 rests. Z and then a C. Z and then a C. All right, and now I have measure 1 done. Now I'm gonna do measure 2. And measure 2 is 4 Ds, and they're all gonna be quarter notes. So I'm gonna draw my note heads first because then I can space my notes out a little bit better. If I draw my note heads first, we want them to be as evenly spaced as possible. Okay, and then I'm going to put my stems on, and I'm going to make sure that my stems come down to the same length this is, because these are all the same note, D. 2 stems, 3 stems, 4 stems. Okay, so now I'm done with measure 2. Now measure 3 is the same as measure 1, and measure 4 is the same as measure 2. So all I have to do is copy measure 1 into measure 3 and copy measure 2 into measure 4. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. So first of all, I'm gonna draw my 2 note heads. And there, Eighth note heads are a little closer together than quarter notes. So now I'm going to draw my stems, one, two, and I'm going to connect them and make it a little bit thicker. And then I'm going to put in my three rests, my Z, and then a C, Z, and then a C, and Z, and then a C. Now, I don't like those. I think they're not spaced quite right. So I'm going to go ahead and erase it and redo it. I'm going to spread this one over a little bit. Z, C, a Z, C, a Z, and then a C. Okay, and now I'm going to draw my four quarter notes over here. So I'm going to draw my note heads first. One, two, remember they're egg-shaped. Three, four, good. And now I'm going to put my stems on. So one, two, three, four. And you want to make sure that your stems are all coming down at the same length, okay? So that's good. So now we're done drawing the notes of our first line and the rests. So now what we're going to do is add some other things. So the first thing that we're going to add are some down bows and up bows. Remember, a down bow is down to the right, away from your body, and an up bow is up to the left toward your body. So we're going to put those on here. And the first note is going to be a down bow, so I'm going to draw, it's like a box without the bottom. And then the next note is going to be an up bow, so I'm going to draw it like this. So that's what it will look like. And I'm going to then skip the rest and go to second measure and put a down bow and then an up bow and a down bow and then an up bow. And then measure three, down bow and up bow. Measure four, down bow, up bow, down bow, up bow. And now that's our down and up bows for line one. Now, we're gonna add one more thing on here before we are done with this. We're gonna put some counting on. Actually, I have two things, I think. So we're gonna put some counting on. So first of all, we know that our meter is 4/4, so we're never gonna go higher than 4 in counting. So I'm gonna put one and, just like that. One and, use a plus sign for and then I'm gonna do rest, rest, rest. And I'm just gonna use R for the rest and use a capital R because it looks better. Then I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna do one, two, three, four. Okay, and now in measure three, I'm gonna do the same thing I did in measure one. I'm gonna do one and then I'm gonna do rest, rest, rest. Now, every time we have a bar line, the next note is always gonna be one. So this is one, two, three, four. So if you notice, after every bar line, the next number is one. Bar line, one. Bar line, one. Now the way we would clap and count this is like this. We would go one and rest, rest, rest. One, two, three, four. One and rest, rest, rest. One, two, three, four. That's how we clap and count the first line. Now we're gonna add one last thing on here and that's D. I'm just gonna put a D under the first note. And that's so that we remember that all these notes are D, open D. And that's how you draw the first line of Happy Blues for Viola.